Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 60. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Problem 60. We have 3a to the 4th b plus 12a to the 2nd b to the 2nd, and we want to see which one of four options it's equal to. So what we have to do with this is factor it, basically make up some parentheses. Now, a lot of things are going on with this. We have a number, we have one type of variable, and a different type of variable. It's best to just focus on one thing at a time. So let me make my parentheses. Now, look at just the numbers. Forget the A's and B's. Look at the 3 and the 4. What comes out of both? 3 can come out of both. 3 goes into 3 evenly, 3 goes into 12 evenly. So now we're done with the numbers. Move on to the first variable now, which is the a's. I have an a to the 4th and an a to the 2nd. I want to take out as much as I can from both. A to the 2nd is as big as I can go with both of them. Certainly more will come out of a to the 4th, but to take it out of both, a to the 2nd is as big as I can go. And now the last variable, the b, right? Once I'm done with the numbers and the a's, forget about them. Just now look at the b. Just I have b in one of them and b to the 2nd in the other. I want the biggest thing that can come out of both. That would just be b, because the first chunk, the 3 a to the 4th b, is kind of limiting the b to just the b to the first power. So the second chunk, the 12 a squared b squared, I can take out another b, but in order to make it come out of both, I have to just do b to the first. Now that I've decided what to put in front of the parentheses, now I ask myself, what do I multiply in the parentheses to get back what was here originally? Well, again, we have numbers, A's, and B's. Numbers and two different types of variables. So first of all, look at just the numbers. Forget the A and B. 3 times what will give me back a 3? Well, times 1. Now look at the A's. Forget everything else, just look at the A's. A to the 2nd times what will put me back up to A to the 4th? Well, another A to the 2nd. A to the 2nd times A to the 2nd, I add the exponents, would be A to the 4th. And then B times what would give me B? Well, the B's all set. I've got it. So it's 1a squared. Or we could just really write a squared. We don't need the one in front. So now move on to the second piece, 12a to the 2nd, b to the 2nd. I have to multiply times something with the number in front to get back the 12a to the 2nd, b to the 2nd. First of all, don't forget the sign. It's going to be a plus. 3 times what will give me back a 12? Again, at this point, I'm not even concerned with a and b. I'm just looking at the numbers. 3 times what will give me a 12? 3 times 4. Now, numbers are done. Next, look at just the a's. Forget the numbers and the b's, just the a's. A to the 2nd times what is a to the 2nd? Well, it's all set. I've already got it. It's there. And then b times what will give me b to the 2nd? Well, times b to the 1st. B times b to the 2nd. So I have it written in the parentheses 1a squared plus 4b. I don't really need the 1. So let me write it a squared plus 4b in the parentheses. And the 3a squared b in front will stay in front. Now, does this match with one of my four options that are given? Yes, it does. Option D is a perfect match. So the answer for number 60 is option D.